This recording is protected by copyright. No part may be reproduced without the prior permission of the University of South Australia.
I'm Dr. Carl Driesner. I am the program director, or the person that's in charge of the Bachelor of Management Marketing degree. So I help set the program up, I monitor the courses, I talk to students, I help students achieve what they want to achieve through coming to university. So I'm very often a point of contact for students when you come into the university, and you'll see me around, and often I see a lot of different students. So just going to talk a little bit about marketing today. I mean, we're quite familiar with what marketing is. Marketing is about selling, it's about understanding, but it is more than that, because obviously to sell we need to have some things going right for us. One of the things we need to know about is our customers, so we've got to be able to engage in market research. We've got to have a good understanding of our business, so we've got to know some things about economics, we've got to know some things about management, we've got to know some things about accounting, we've got to know some things about law, so we have a good understanding of how our business works, because if we don't know how our business works, we're not going to be able to make successful marketing plans that will ultimately return income to our business. And it doesn't really matter where you end up working, all organisations require marketing of some sort, because marketing is the interface between the outside world and the business itself. It's understanding what people want, what the business can deliver, and matching those two things in such a way that the business can either return a profit to its shareholders or its owners, or if you're working for a charity, generate money so that you can actually engage in the activities which your charity is doing. Government departments also engage in marketing, so the Department of Environment and Heritage has got a whole lot of activities it engages in around publicising its national forest that we have in South Australia. So marketing is also about building products, it's also about developing awareness, and it's also about things beyond just brands and logos. So I'm going to show you a quick ad, and you'll very quickly know what this ad's about. It's a little bit old, maybe you've all seen this ad before. Right, so immediately that ad started playing, we knew what it was about. Right, we didn't need the branding, so we had the Apple logo at the end, and it told us it was about the iPod. But right at the beginning of the ad, there were some elements in that ad which immediately identified it as being an iPod and being related to Apple product. So that was a really nice example of marketing being successful without actually showing logos, because marketing is about understanding logos and using logos, but it's also about building distinctive assets, which are those things aside from the brand and the logo, which are associated with that brand so that you know what they are and you can use them in your advertising. So it increases people's knowledge and awareness of the particular product. And Apple's actually a company which has done that very well. Now, why would you want to study marketing? Well, there's a few reasons, but I think really a quite important one is this one down the bottom for a lot of people. Now, marketing is a degree which will allow you to travel. You can study marketing, you understand business. Business and marketing is the same in any country in the world. It's the same skill sets required. You can study in Australia, you can work in the States, you can work in Europe, you can work in the UK, you can work in Asia, you can work anywhere you like. You don't need to requalify as a marketing professional. Marketing is also a very broad area. So marketing isn't just sales, it's not just selling product, it's understanding people, it's building advertising, it's discussing within the business, it's developing new product. So there's a vast range of careers inside marketing. All businesses need marketing. It's expanding, so we'll see these days that a lot of services like accountants and lawyers will have a marketing professional within their team. So more and more businesses are engaging in marketing because they understand that competition is increasing. Right? Increasingly in Australia, we're faced with global competitors. They are very good at marketing. We need to lift the abilities of marketing within Australia. So there are lots of opportunities for jobs in marketing. And as I said, travel is certainly a good option. Quite attractive. So at the UniFSA, there's a whole lot of things which make us particularly important or a particularly good place to study marketing. First of all, we actually have a school of marketing. So we have an entire school which is devoted to teaching marketing, conducting research in marketing, and engaging with the marketing community. One of the really important things about our school is the very strong industry links we have. We aren't just a bunch of academics who sit in offices and don't talk to people outside in the world. we engage in market research, so we engage with corporations, we know what they want, we know what's important to corporations, and we teach those skills to our students. We also conduct research in marketing, so that is developing knowledge about marketing for the purposes of making better marketers. Corporations pay us or sponsor us to do this research, and we also teach into those corporations. So we run seminars with a whole range of corporations around Australia, globally, including the UK, US, and Europe. And I'll show you some of those a little bit later. And that's through our affiliation with the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute, which is the research arm of the school. Because as a university, there are two big things universities do. One is teaching, which is what you're here about today. The other is engaging in research. And it's the research which really lifts the teaching, because research ultimately ends up in journals, which ends up in the textbooks, which is what you are learning about. So the research that we engage in at the university here through the Ehrenberg-Bass Knowledge, the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute, develops knowledge which we teach to our students. Some of this knowledge is not yet in the textbooks, hasn't got that far, though we're in the process now of actually writing a textbook for our students, which we'll bring into the curriculum. Also through the School of Marketing, we've got a wide range of electives. So within this degree, I'll talk a little bit about the structure in a little while, but there are a range of marketing electives you can do, as well as a large number of electives elsewhere in business and indeed throughout the university. And finally, unlike the old days, you might say, some of you might have been to university before, there's actually a whole lot of new ways that people can study in very flexible manners. So we put our things online. This lecture here has been recorded. When we teach in these lectures through semester, those lectures are recorded and placed online, so students can actually access lectures without having to attend the room, which is why we sometimes end up with five or six people in here. So what do you study when you're here? A very important foundation is buyer and consumer behaviour, so understanding how people behave when they buy things. So what happens when an individual buys? What happens when we're selling to large groups of people? How do those people behave in our large groups? Obviously, a little bit of advertising is very important. Market research is a really important element as well. If we want to develop products which suit people's needs, we need to know something about what it is that people are looking for. Brand management's an important area, so that is that area I was talking about before of knowing what are the important things which are linked to your brand and using those in your advertising. Sales management, obviously an aspect of marketing which most people are familiar with, but as you can see here, that's not the only element of marketing which we think is important to teach. And finally, some marketing strategy. So marketing needs to fit within a business, it needs to be consistent with the aims of that business, and you need to develop strategy to ultimately make your marketing activity successful, which is about developing products which meet people's needs and returning income to those businesses. So the program structure itself, we've got 24 courses which are spread over 3 years, so that's essentially 8 courses a year. You do 4 courses per study period. Now, there is certainly plenty of flexibility. You can study full-time or part-time. So full-time is 3 or 4 subjects a semester. Part-time is anything less than that. Obviously, if you study 1 subject a semester, you're going to be at university a long time. But to support that, you can actually study outside of the usual semesters. So you can study in winter school, you can study in summer school, and there are also some overlapping study periods. So you can actually study part-time but get through 8 courses a year. So you're not studying 4 per study period, because quite often a lot of students these days are working, so it's really important to be able to fit in study and work. We offer study both internally at campus and externally. As I said, we record all the lectures and they're posted online. We have extensive online materials available for students. And for people who are working, we have a lot of after-hour classes. So quite often, tutorials will be run from 5 till 7. So if you're working during the day, you can attend tutorials after work hours and still participate in those group activities. And ultimately, the program can lead to honours and to postgraduate programs if that's your particular area of interest. So the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute is where our honours and postgraduate programs reside. And the students who move into this area end up having a lot of interaction with our corporate sponsors elsewhere in other countries. So to get into this program, it's going to require an ATAR of 71.85. That was the cutoff for 2012. It'll be something similar, so roughly 72 for this year. If you get an ATAR of 75, you are guaranteed entry into the program. So that will be straight through. There are no particular prerequisites that you need to study at school to enter the program. As I said, to understand or to be a marketer, you need to have a good understanding of business. The program is structured around 8 areas that you study within the division of business so that you understand what's required in business. So the prerequisites are supplied by that base study. Talked about this already, internal, external options. We offer a full range of materials online. Our school offers everything that we do is available online. So all our courses you can study online. All the materials are available online, so you can download those and look at them at home. You can podcast them, so the lectures you can look at on your iPods and iPads and everything else, as well as those other computers that you may have, the old PCs. Full-time and part-time, after-hours works, lecture recordings. Talked about that already. We'll move on. A really important part of our project is experiential learning. So this is where we are really focused on getting our graduates ready for the workplace, and there's a couple of ways that we do this. Our capstone element here is the company placement, where we put students who have applied for this particular program into a business for 2 days a week for a semester. So this is our marketing project. That takes up 2 subjects. So if you do this particular course here, that's worth 2 subjects, and you will be working inside a business working on a particular marketing program. So that you do in your last semester at the university, so you've had a very thorough grounding in what marketing is about. You apply for this particular program, you need to achieve a GPA, or you need to get a pass on average, so you've got to basically pass all your courses. If you do that, you're eligible to participate. We also provide electives credit for work experience. University gets you ready for work, it provides you a ticket, as it were, but what really makes you different, because a lot of people basically these days get university degrees, what's going to make you different is the things you do outside of university. So as the program director, for me, I think it's really important for students to think about the other things they can add on to their degree. So it's important to get involved in things like the student association. Now, it's a bit of politics, which you may or may not be interested in, but what that teaches you about is interacting with people. You're managing the student association, it's your responsibility, so you learn a lot of skills. It teaches you around running meetings, it teaches around interacting with people, develops your networking skills, all of which I'm sure your parents will tell you are vital to be successful in the workplace. So university for me is not just about getting the degree, it is about character development and seeing and developing yourself and engaging in a process of lifelong learning. So as part of that, getting work experience is really important. So work experience is something you organise, maybe through family, maybe through friends, maybe simply through going and knocking on a door and working in a business in a marketing role. If you do that and you do it for about 24 hours in total, we'll look at giving you elective credit. So it'll actually count towards your study of the marketing degree, because we think work experience is absolutely critical to making you the best marketer that you can be. We also run a final competitive situation for our students. So our marketing strategy element has 2 components. First of all, there's a whole lot of theory around marketing strategy. And then we actually want our students to apply what they've learnt in the theoretical course. So in this situation, we actually put our students into teams and they're competing against other student teams in a computer simulation. And it takes up quite a lot of time. You'll be competing quite intensively with various other people in the course, and it's wrapped up with a presentation you make to senior staff inside the School of Marketing of about half an hour. At the moment, you're sort of thinking, well, half an hour, that's, you know, it's a long time to talk, but actually it's not very long at all. One of the skills you get out of that is working out what actually matters, what do I need to talk about, how can I talk about that within only 30 minutes. We also offer masterclasses, so for our students who are at the upper end of performance, we offer the opportunity to come in and talk to our researchers. So the researchers at the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute who engage with corporations and industry, as well as teaching our normal classes, run masterclasses, which is basically just a step up from what you usually get in the undergraduates, a little bit more postgraduate, as it were. So the marketing project, as I said, 2 courses over the year, have to apply for it, it's done in 3rd year, and basically you're gaining work experience on a particular marketing problem inside a corporation. And what's important here is tying together the theoretical aspects you learn at university plus the practical elements you've got through either work experience or through the integrated marketing topics, and applying it towards a particular project for those corporations that you're working for. So you're placed, it's not just by yourself in this particular instance, you're placed with another student, so there are a couple of you inside that business. These are some of the corporations we've worked for before. So we've had Balfour's, we did a project for them, National Pharmacies, we've done a couple for them. The Australian Prawn Farmers Association was particularly interesting. We had two students working for them. And part of that project, they unfortunately had to go to the United States. So there was a little bit, and they weren't too happy about that, but they did go there. And there was some travel up to Brisbane as well, because that's where that particular project is was based. So I can't promise that everyone gets to go to the United States, but some of these projects, because basically these guys were interested in looking at how to market into the US. So as part of that, the two students went over and engaged in some market research and talked to a whole bunch of suppliers and distributors in the United States and wrote a report for Australian prawn farmers. So there are some really good opportunities here through this project for our students. And quite often we find actually that the students that work with these companies get jobs in the company afterwards. So if it suits the student, it suits the business, and they're looking for a marketing person, they've had this student work with them for 6 months basically, over the period of a semester, and they will often make some job offers to students out of that. So the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute, this is our research arm. This is a really important part of the school, and it's really important because it tells us as academics what businesses are interested in marketing. And what businesses are interested in marketing is what we need to teach to our students. We get this through two ways. One, we have a bunch of corporations sit on the board of this institute, so they tell us what they want us to research. And two, we work directly with corporations. So we are conducting research for them, we are developing marketing knowledge for them, and we give it back to them through corporate seminars. We're asking here the big questions. Some of these look a bit simple, but they're actually really quite difficult. There's a lot of argument about how these things happen. So how do brands grow? How do I go from being 5% of a market to 10%? What do I have to do? What does it look like? How do brands compete? And essentially, how does marketing work? There's quite a lot of discussion we have in these areas. One thing about how brands compete, quite often some marketers have this impression that you compete only with a very small subgroup of brands. But our perception is, as a marketer, if you're Apple, you're not just competing against PCs, you're also these days competing against Samsung. You are competing against everyone else out there in the market. And that's really quite an important message. And what goes with that is anyone who's in the market for a phone is potentially your customer. There aren't just people who buy Apple. There aren't people who just buy Samsung. People will buy anything which meets their needs. These are some of the corporations we do some work with. So Mars, probably people are quite familiar with. So we do a lot of work with Mars in Australia and also internationally. In Australia, we do market research for Mars. So we look at what people think about their chocolate brands. But we also provide educational seminars for the Mars Corporation as a whole. And Mars is much more than just Mars bars. Right? They also own Master Foods, they own Whiskers, they own quite a large number of different food products. ANZ, Kellogg's, BP, Elders is an interesting brand that we do some work for. It's particularly interesting because it's based in Adelaide. So they sit on our board, and we also conduct some market research for them. Colgate Palmolive and Channel 10. We also do some work for media companies in the US as well. So ESPN, Turner Broadcasting are some of the ones that we work for. Unilever, Procter and Gamble, these are names you may or may not be familiar with, but they are really important brands in the consumer space. So they make things like toothpaste, shampoo, a whole range, soap for example, a whole range of different products. And we conduct research for them and help them market their products better. So I've talked a bit about this already, but how does this benefit our students? One, we know that what we're teaching our students is what corporations are interested in. And two, we are teaching our students the latest cutting edge research. They are the two key benefits that we get from the affiliation with the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute, and that is really a big benefit for our students. Where can you go with marketing? There are lots of opportunities. Marketing is much more, as I said, than just sales. Obviously, yes, you can go into sales roles, but there is an awful lot more out there. There's advertising, obviously quite an attractive area for a lot of people because, again, that's something that's quite familiar. Public relations, there's media. So media buying here in terms of understanding how people view TV, how people read newspapers, not as in start on the left and work your way across, but how a large group of people will consume different media. There's a lot of different industries you can go into, so as well as large typical corporations, you can go into the arts industry, government. Most corporations these days and most areas you can think of are starting to think about marketing if they haven't been doing so already. Important question then is where your degree can take you. Laura Waterhouse is one of our students of recently graduated, and she's now working at La Casa del Formaggio. And we had a little bit of discussion with her just recently, because you might have noticed that La Casa del Formaggio, which is an Adelaide company, recently changed all their packaging and labelling. And she was actually involved in that process. They had a particular one style of how they did their packaging and labels. She was involved in changing those, designing the new packages and labels, and rolling that out across their product line into various supermarkets and people that sell for them. I think about now, I've probably talked enough. What I'll do is get one of our current students up. So Kaelin Moore has been a student of ours for a couple of years. I'll actually just let him tell you a bit about what he's doing already.
Kaelin Moore, I'm currently a third year student here in Bachelor of Marketing Management. And it's hard to know what you want to do when you leave school. But if you're interested in the business and marketing side like I was, it's a pretty easy option just to study here at UniSA. It's a great place to study any business degree, especially in marketing. As you know, with the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute, it's based here in City West, so you can actually get up-to-date relevant information, which is really good for your assignments. And also you've got the core eight business subjects, so you've got accounting, you've got management and all those kind of subjects. So if you don't find marketing is your strong point, you can actually change into these subjects and focus on those as a core course. And it also gives you a broader understanding of your business. So I currently work in a cooperative program with GM Holden, and it's given me a greater understanding of the business so I can effectively work in a great, huge environment. Lecturers and tutors are very experienced. Most of them work at Ehrenberg-Bass, so they're well-educated and they know what they're talking about. And they're really approachable for course-related stuff and not for course-related stuff. So that's a good positive. And I've also been given the opportunity several times in my degree to be a class representative. And that's basically where we meet up with the head of the marketing courses, and we actually discuss the positives, the negatives, ways for improvement with each degree and each course. And it really shows the value they have on student voice and what's actually important. So just about a bit about me, I'm currently working at GM Holden as a co-op student in sales and marketing here in SA. And my degree has given me the knowledge to actually apply myself in my position, so I can actually, I've been given a special consideration to apply for the graduates program for next year, even though I haven't graduated. So I'd like to thank you for giving me your time, and I wish you the best for your future. And just apply yourself and make the university experience what you can. So thank you.
You know, no, come back up here. So one of the reasons I wanted Kaelin to come up and talk to you all is that Kaelin, for me, epitomises what you need to do as a university student. He's come here, he studied hard, he's got some pretty good grades, but importantly, what he then did is got off his own bum and went out and organised this position at Holden's. So Kaelin's done really well in that he's actually working at Holden's. He's had interaction with dealers and networks all around South Australia and around Australia. And in fact, I think just last week he had to go to Melbourne, and he's told me he was a little bit sweaty, which I can understand, because he had to present to the senior management team in Holden's. So he had 11 of the 12 senior Holden's managers in front of him. He was supposed to talk for 10 minutes, and they let him go after half an hour. So the fact that he had a whole bunch of interesting things to say to them about how to improve the Holden program, I thought was really good. So I was really proud and pleased we had a UniSA graduate providing some advice to Holden's about how to make the experience of students inside, well, he's not a graduate yet, but he's going to be pretty soon, how to improve the experience for students, and so that Holden's can get more out of that experience from its students as well. And I think Kaelin, as I said, is a really great example of someone who has taken that extra step and, is going to have a really good career. Whether or not it's with Holden's, it's going to be somewhere, because he is doing more than just the degree. And that is what's really important. So thank you once again.
I'd just like to say as well, as Carl said before, with travelling, I've been employed with Holden end of last year, and they've flown me over to Melbourne several times, and there's great opportunities for me to move to Detroit, to anywhere General Motors is actually in the world. So if you're just open to travel, which I said I have been, you've got great opportunities, and pretty much the world's your little oyster, so do what you want.
Great, thank you very much. And what's important also is that it shows the flexibility of the marketing degree. So Caelan's done 2 years of study. He's then taken a year off his study to work for the Holdens for a year. And he's not doing that for nothing. They're actually paying him while he's there. And then he'll come back and finish his degree and apply for the graduate program, which I think he's probably got a pretty good shot at as well. So really, for me, you know, that's just a great story. It's a good example of what you can do coming out of marketing. So if we've got any interest in business and law careers, so you can do a double degree between marketing and law. There's some information about that there, so you need to come back on Tuesday on the 11th of September. Here's some contact details. Probably the easiest one to write down is my email address or the telephone number. Some contact details from myself. We've also got our student administrator, Cheryl Dalitz, who actually just makes me look good. She does a whole lot of work for students, make sure students are in the right programs, will answer all your questions, and I get to take all the glory, so that's really quite nice for me. But at that point, we will wrap up and see if you've got any questions about marketing, about what you might do. I mean, one thing we didn't cover too well is the structure of the degree. So as Caelan said, there are 8 core subjects you do in business. And as he said, one of the important things about that is it gives you flexibility. If you start marketing and decide you don't like it, and what you really like is accounting, you can go and change into an accounting degree. Conversely, if you want to do a double degree, you could do a double degree with marketing and accounting. There are then another 9 subjects you study in marketing. So we offer a wide range of subjects that you'll be looking at. Importantly, there are 7 subjects where you get to choose what you want to do, 7 electives. And as the program director, I have a very liberal view on what I will accept as electives. You can do anything you like in business, but essentially, if you want to do something outside of the school of business and you want to study something in philosophy, something in project management, something in art, something around international relations or politics, I will let you do that. Because from my perspective, what's important is to get your degree, to get your marketing degree, but also to follow the things that you find interesting, which will make you a more employable person because you are showing your breadth of knowledge, but also just give you the opportunity to develop your interests and see and follow up with those things that you want to do. So having said that, I'll come back to my earlier question. Are there any questions you'd like me to answer? Stunned you all into silence. No questions? I will be down at the booth, so if you do actually have a question you want to come down and have a quick chat later on, I'll be there. If I'm not there, there'll be someone there that can answer your questions. So we might draw a curtain on it at this point in time. So thank you very much. If you've got any questions, you can come down now and I'll be sitting around for a few minutes.